Alright, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to our Let's Play of Medal of Honor Underground. I'm the Ninja Stalker. And right behind me is my cat. So, load the game.
There's a new mission that's suddenly opened up, but it's strictly on a volunteer basis.
Monte Cassino.
This is the town of Cassino, the gateway to Rome. And this is the abbey that sits above Cassino, on a small mountain that is the most strategic spot in a most strategic town. The Allies have been stuck here for weeks, unable to take the hill or the abbey from the Germans, and time is running out. Unlike the ruins on Crete, Command has made the decision that it's time to attack the site from the air, no matter the consequences to history or scholarship. The abbey has been there for over 1400 years, and tomorrow, it's going to be bombed into oblivion. Now, here's where it gets complicated. Just within the last hour, we finished translating a message that was transmitted from the abbey last night. It was written in, of all things, Latin. What it says is quite troubling. The author claims to be a monk sympathetic to the Allied cause, someone who doesn't want to see any more loss of life on either side. Now here's the really distressing part. The monk claims that there are several downed American pilots being held inside as prisoners of war. He says they're confined to cells in the old part of the abbey and would surely be killed in a raid. There certainly have been a lot of airmen from the 8th Air Force lost over Italy, so the monk's claim is not without merit. But let me be clear, Manon. We don't have any independent confirmation of the monk's story, or if he even is a monk. The language and diction check out, but the Nazis have fooled us before. This all just might be a clever ruse on their part to prevent an aerial bombardment. The mission is fairly straightforward. Clandestinely infiltrate the abbey, rescue the POWs, and disrupt the Germans' operation by destroying whatever equipment you can. The monk's message contained very specific instructions on how to sneak inside, which you can read on the plane if you accept this mission.
Let's do it. Roundabout. Benvenuto in Italia, Manon. Benvenuto, huh? Similar to Benvenito. Let's see, we've got a difficult job for you, so let's get right to the details. Monte Cassino has proven very tough nut to crack, and our success thus far has been negligible. Negligible. In fact, the first phase of your mission will be to actually gain access to the abbey, not a minor feat in itself. We think your best chance is through the back entrance leading up to the abbey's crypt. Unfortunately, getting there means going through the supply depot protected by a very nasty guard tower. I'm afraid you're going to have to find an alternate way into the abbey. There are less used forest paths that go around the abbey and link up to the main road. This is convenient since we want you to stop a series of supply trucks from supporting the Monte Cassino. They must not be allowed to reach the abbey. Take out the trucks, any supplies you find, and the guard tower for good measure. Watch your back, Manon. Alright. Negligible. I can't believe I didn't say that correctly. Negligible. Rolls off the tongue nicely now. And then Benvenuto, Italia. I guess that's Italian. Because Benvenito, I heard that. I think that's, it might be Spanish. I'm not sure. I know I've heard that before from a comedian. I forgot how he did it. He was like, Benvenuto al mal de Arizona. And I'm guessing that's Spanish. I just haven't used that word before. If it is Spanish, and I should know better. In Spanish myself. Oh, we have a pounder fouse. We have two grenades. What?
Oh,
don't see how he was still alive after a few shots out of the 45. But I meant, like, to pick it back up. Alright, so I'm a kleptomaniac. Whatever. Thank you. Alright, so we made it to the crypt. Now let's see if we got all of the stars that we needed. Alright, we did. Colt 45 was the preferred weapon, accuracy 66%. That's better than usual. Let's go ahead and save. So, prisoners of war. The next phase of your mission is an errand of mercy. You see, we've received word that a group of pilots from the 8th Air Force had recently been taken prisoner when shot down over Monte Carlo. We don't want them on the list of casualties once we start bombing. They've all earned a free ticket home, Manon, but first you must get them out of there. Locate and free the CO of the group. It's likely the Germans are interrogating him. Once free, he'll help you locate the others. You'll most likely need to provide. You most likely need to provide cover as he jimmies the locks, imprisoning his comrades. It's very important all the pilots make it out before the bombing commences. Once the pilots are out, search for a command center. We suspect it's hidden somewhere inside the abbey. Despite heavy shelling on the German positions, they've still maintained order, so we suspect their command center to be in the abbey itself. Locate, eliminate both it and the command staff. Alright, we can do that. No problem. We're gonna stay with the 45 because it's a unique weapon, if you ask me. Alright, there we go. I was like, wait a minute, what the hell? Okay, so we're in a crypt. There's some crypts. Some Sten rounds, apparently. Steel hand grenaded grenade. What the hell? Door's locked.
What is yours?
What took you so long?
Alright, so I think this is the CEO of the 8th Air Force captured prisoner group. Yep, captain's freed. Prisoner's probably going back where we came from. He's running, he's got his head up into the air.
Oh,
chain. They're gonna try and bomb this place. Look at all this art, man. It's this art and architecture. Oh, Captain! Oh, Captain survived, alright. Please, calm down. Thank you. down here still? Yes, there is. Yes, there is. There we go. Alright, let me deal with this cat. What's up? Hey. Mayhem in the monastery. Sorry, Manon, but your mission's about to become even more difficult. Because Monte Cassino is heavily fortified, we need to make sure that certain elements do not survive the bombing. So, on your way out of the abbey, it's imperative you take care of a few things. First, take out any supplies you lay eyes on. If our bombing doesn't achieve the desired results, then this will become a war of attrition, meaning the sooner the enemy's out of supplies, the sooner the battle's over. Second, find the quartermaster's ledger so we can gouge just how long the Germans can hold out. Finally, destroy all of the half-tracks you encounter. Those vehicles will make mincemeat of our troops if any are allowed to survive. So find cover, give those vehicles a heavy dose of explosive ordnance, and get yourself out of there. Be careful, Manon. This is a tough one. Alright. That's how you throw a grenade, jackass. Oh, that was lucky. And that was too. You don't need those kneecaps when you're going. Oh, shit. probably submachine gun ammunition. health.
The European air war that started with the RAF in the Battle of Britain was continued by the forces of the Army Air Corps. Nimble fighters piloted by brave young men roamed the countryside, attacking any target of opportunity, disrupting the German war machine on the ground and in the air, while heavy American bombers made daring daylight raids against the Third Reich. But there was a heavy price to be paid. By war's end, almost one out of every 10 Americans killed had been a member of the 8th Air Force.
Yeah. Because I think the British were... Aw, man, I didn't get a good rating. I gotta replay that mission. I think it was because of the health. Let me see. I think it was because in World War II, the Americans and the British agreed on day and night fire raids or bombing raids and the likes that has anything to do with air power. The Americans agreed to do daytime raiding for fighters and bombers, while the British would go to nighttime. The problem with that is nighttime you couldn't see as much, so the British didn't get as much targets hit. But during the daytime you were easily spotted, so you can see what you were going to bomb, but you were going to get shot out of the sky a lot more often than nighttime raids. So that was the thing right there. We're going to have to replay that. Yep. Play the mission. It was because of the health. I bet you it was the health. So, we'll go at it again. Probably still had me registers aiming at the wall.
Knock the ship.
Thank you.
had to look back because I thought there was something on that walkway or that on the stairs.
Got it.
fuckers hit hard. Look at this horse shit. I have got to make the perilous journey on back, because I don't have the health. There's got to be health somewhere. I really hope there is, otherwise I'm going to get a bad rating. Yet again. So, let's keep our eyes peeled. I didn't look up here, but maybe there might have been something up here. I can't remember. Somewhere that I've left behind, or maybe even forgotten about. That's over 75% right there. Thank you. You imagine, like, right at the end, I get shot up? That would suck. Alright, we've already seen that. There we go. Secret code discovered. Let's save. Hope you guys enjoyed the let's play there. We got a chance to see a little extra because we had to replay the mission just to get the third star, but hey, we got it done. We finished that, so next mission will be some other time. Hope you guys enjoyed. You guys take care, and please have yourselves a great night.